Hello, peeps. This is video number 6. I'm starting here where I left off. I'm video number 5 at the east end of Pelican Cove. I'm gonna be heading that way, south, and then east again. Heading over there at Point Udall. I left off by this palm tree. Yeah. That's west, north. You see the islands today. East, south. Heading south for about a mile. That's a Cormorant condo. See if I can make the Christiansted in the town. Don't have any rock cliffs to climb around. Gotta go by the WAPA, that's our local power plant. I might have to go around that. I don't know if I can hike over their pier, but we'll see. Another beautiful day in paradise. It's harder walking on this sand than it is in rocks. Pelican Cove used to have a lot more palm trees than that. It was like a pincushion, there were so many. But you know, over all the years with the hurricane, taking out about half of them. See if I can make the seaplane shuttle terminal. If I can get that far, it'd be good. And then from there, I'll probably get to a little past Buccaneer. And camera shut off. Oh well. Detroit, man.
Ivory Eye. Come to the VI.
Got that Caribbean Ocean.
Old pier here. Been hurricanized. Haven't walked down this coast in a while. St. Croix is a pretty big island. It's for anybody who's not familiar with it, it's 84 square miles. I don't really know exactly how much coast it has because of all the coves and twists and turns. I'm figuring 60 miles. It's about 28 miles long. The South Shore would be a lot more easy hiking because you don't have the rock cliffs like you have on the North Shore. On Pomegranate Bush. Incursion terminology, gone bush means like if something is beat up, broken, lost, a gone bush. They got their own language here, you know. The Kushan Deman. We pass it by the Condo Row. And then the Wapa. That's Mill Harbor down there. After that, it gets kind of a piece of commercial coast. Not very pretty. But its coast, trying to film it all.
It's a cool pond.
At the rope swing. Yeah, fresh Wilson here. I don't got no big bloody hand on it.
Once I get past the town and Gallows Bay, that's when you start getting into the better coast. More beaches and just better overall.
Heading up the condo row. Barefoot. This is easy hiking for the barefoot. Compared to all those rocks.
back to the rock. Piece of driftwood. I don't want to get wet on this trip. Wow, these are sharp rocks sticking out of this wall. Guys are building that. Say, oh, why are you walking on my wall? This is Mill Harbor condominium. Been here a long time. It was built in the 60s. And everything is so dead, man, with this virus. So you don't see no people, man. It's like after the apocalypse. Know what bar that is anymore. It used to be the Serendipity. Got two people. It's open. Nobody in there. Oh. That's Sugar Beach condos. That's Club St. Croix condos. After that part, the coast gets really commercial, kind of ugly piece of coast. I'm gonna have to see. I'm probably gonna have to go around the WAPA. I don't think they'll let you hike over their pier. See if there's any signs posted or anything. If I do, I'll shut the camera there and go around it. See if I can hike over it. Thank you.
So, find any crabs?
No.
All right, have a good day.
That's Breeze's Bar and Restaurant. These turns.
Yeah, tire on the beach. Another tire on the beach.
From here to like Point Udall, it's calm, you know, that everything's inside the reef out there, so you don't get the big waves on the coast. Yeah, I don't want to get wet. Gotta go around all these mangroves. Thank you. here, it seems. And a hurricane chewed this coast up, man.
Ah, a lot of old metal in here, boy.
Watch out where you walk. I got all chewed up by Hurricane Maria. I don't remember these trees being so far in the water. I might have to put my shoes on down here. Looks like a lot of old metal, and I don't know if I can pass over that pier or not. Like I said, this is a commercial piece of coast here. I've been down here a long time. I guess if I have to go around, go through there, make it around this old barge or whatever that is. Didn't know the beach needed tires, man. That's old. That thing's probably been there since the 60s. I don't know why they removed that, man. Got a big old engine on it. Man, that thing's really old. Another tire. Now this is the part I don't know. Can I go over their pier or not? Might have to shut the camera here. And go. I don't know if I can get up around there or I have to go back and go to that other spot. I want to get back to the good coast, but I'm trying to film all of it, so this counts. Every place has its bad places and good places.
dumped all this concrete here. Wow. Can't get through that area. I'm gonna have to go back. I don't think, nah, you can't go around this. We got a fence. And they got it hanging out, so that means they don't want you to cross over that. No sign, though. You could play dumb. I didn't know. That's where the ship comes in to offload the natural gas and the fuel oil. But that's WAPA, our local power authority. Well, I'm gonna have to shut the camera here and go around it. Okay, peeps, to the other side. All right, peeps, back on the other side of the WAPA pier. I had to walk a half a mile to get around it. Heading south and behind the east. It's a pretty creepy piece of shoreline. There's a lot of people camping out in the bush over here. Really don't like coming down these areas. But it is coastline. It counts. That's the town of Christiansted. That's the Seaborn Island Hoppers. They got all kind of people living down here in the bush. A lot of homeless people, you know. I guess that's all over the world. As long as they don't mess with me, I don't care, you know. I don't bother them. Anybody comes out, I'm going swimming. Cameras are waterproof. How's that cruise shine? They ain't taking me down no easy way, boy, I'll tell you that. The man that I done freed water. I go straight out in the ocean. That's my element there. It's one of them camps in there. Once I get out there, then it gets all back to the nice coast, beaches, and you know, it's got some rocky shoreline, but nothing like over there by, you know, the Aus Hill and Judas Fancy and those parts over by Rust Duck Twist. Maybe a seaplane will land while I'm walking by here. We can still see the islands today. That's Buck Island, Green Key over there. Getting closer and closer. I have to walk back the road. I don't really want to walk back through these areas. You don't know who's gonna pop out on you. Nobody around, eh? I don't have to swim out to the reef, do you mind?
Yukon Trucking. That's Hotel on the Key. That's Gallows Bay where those red roofs are. Have to go around the seaplane. I don't think you can hike through their runways there. Not a very pretty piece of coast here. Yeah, I can't even see we're walking on there. Around that. Once I get past the town, ooh, what was that? Slimy. Hey, past all the commercial stuff. Once I get out of Gallows Bay, they got the container port. I'll have to skip around that. This whole coast was full of boats after Maria, all torn up. Seaplane them. Well, no seaplane landed while I was walking by. Can't walk through there. Yeah, look like we're in an apocalyptic zone. Yes, sir, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, feed him in the course, man. Basically, if you want to go down to St. Thomas, just hop on one of them planes and boom, you're there in 40 minutes. We're heading down the boardwalk now. Well, this is officially the town of Kirstenstad, for anybody that doesn't know, St. Croix. This town used to really party, man. But all this virus and no tourists. Much now. That's like walking through a ghost town. The piers got destroyed in Hurricane Maria and haven't rebuilt them yet. Tsunami hazard zone. The Holger Danks. They had some people there eating. Everything else looks closed down. That's the Caravelle Arcade. It looks closed. Looks like we got some Sargasso seaweed coming. That ain't a good sign there, man. A little early for that. That chute's got a few people. Yeah, man.
Come on. You know what? Let's go.
That's Club Comanche. I think they're closed. Small hotel. Brewers Pub.
We got these big tarpons here.
They come up with a chicken bone.
Yeah, well, that's about 30 of them.
Is that what's right there?
Yeah, it's tarpon.
Tarpon?
Yeah, they come up because people feed them. Uh-huh. In a restaurant, you throw the chicken bones and they double them.
Are they good eating?
Oh, no, they're real bony.
No, that's why nobody's bothered.
Yeah, they're huge.
They are?
That would be a good meal right there, huh? That would last a while.
Yeah,
they're getting more and more of them.
There's so many, yeah.
Yeah, they used to start off with a few, and now there's got to be about 30, 40 of them.
Wow.
All right, I'm filming the whole island. I've got to keep moving.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm filming the whole shoreline of the island.
Oh, well, it'll take you one.
Yeah, so that's 60 miles. I started at Carambola. I'm all the way up here. That's Hotel on the Key. At least there was a few people. Wasn't 100% dead. The tarpon seem like they're doing good. Waiting for their brunch. Heard any of those docks yet? King Christian Hotel. Yeah, I'm starting to see those patches of that sargassum. That ain't good so early. That's the fort. That's Gallows Bay down there. I don't know how long this battery's got to be getting close to cropping out here. Back the road. Don't want to hike down through all that coast again. Actually, that's not sargassum, that's another seaweed, which is good, because that one isn't like the sargassum. Gotta get around that wall. over here.
Been a long time. Been around them all. Slippery here.
Years. Yeah.
Come on, I get soaked.
Ow!
One.
That's a lot of those little buggers. Yeah, they're everywhere. Oh, there's one out. Bunch of sea urchins over there. A lot of history here in this part. Fort was built in the 1700s. See all the old pieces of glass people have picked up. These are from old rum bottles and stuff like that. Pretty cool. Never know what you find in here. Look at that. I've been noticing that a lot of masks on the beach now. New pollution. You know. How deep is it over here? Sea urchins right there. Yeah. Try not to get soaked here, man. You're right on this trip. Shit. Going through the real commercials parts. Another mask. A lot of sea urchins in here. This is a pretty gnarly piece of coast here. Never know what's laying under here with all that history. Could be some doubloons. Camera's still going. Fort. Maybe if I can make it to the marina. Got a friend over there, go check him out. Really can't go through that way. Be careful walking around here, man. A lot of old metal and sea urchins. Okay. cannon in here somewhere. Wow. That's some sharp shit there. Ryan's boat repair. See if we can get around here. That's really slippery. I'll have to skip around the container port. Can't hike around that. I won't let you in there. That battery's got to be getting close to running out. I'd like to make the marina. Then I could park there and do the next leg. Got a ways to go back. I don't want to go back that coast. Well, they really need to do some work down here on this coast here. Do something with it. Clean it up, man. I did get further than I thought I would. Heading into Gallows Bay here. Gotta really be careful walking around here. There's so much old metal and stuff. I would have put my shoes on, but then they're gonna be soaked on the way back. Put them on when I get out of here. It's not anybody. Have to go around this. That's the Gallows Bay container port.
This time I'm going to the camera stops. We go through the Dallas Bay Marina. If I make it there, it's right around the corner over here. I smell hamburgers, man. This is the smaller container port. The big one's over there on the south shore near Lime Tree, the oil refinery. That's the main one out there. Only the smaller cargo ships come in here. Battery's about to go, man. Chickens. McNuggets. My precious. After the marina, there's no obstructions. You can hike the whole coast. Heading over that way. That's where the coast starts again. I don't think I've ever seen this many boats in here. Oh, says no fishing. Boat owners only, huh? What about the coast? I thought all coasts were public. Yeah, big iguana. Two iguanas. Three iguanas. I hear they taste like chicken. Four iguanas. Five iguanas. Ooh, that one jumped in the water, swimming like a fish. What? Oh, that thing went down like a fish.
Where the hell did he go?
They're running. I don't want to be chicken. This is going to jump in the water. You going for a swim? Oh yeah, he's flying. Slabs of granite here. It ain't from this island. But I know the rocks. Yeah, next trip I'll park here and then head around towards the Buccaneer. See how far I get. See, I never know where the video is going to exactly end. That's why I'm keeping it systematically. Now how am I going to get around that? Yeah, definitely ain't climbing over that. I don't think you can get through over here. Fence. Definitely ain't climbing over that. Pretty cool little old dragliner bucket. Alright, I meet on the other side. Alright, this is where I turn the camera off up here. On this old shipwreck. This shipwreck's been here since like, I don't know, 60s, 50s. I mean, as long as I remember, it's been an old, you know, I can't believe they haven't moved it. Really should move that thing. Wreck boat with that. Oh, it's old metal and boat parts and stuff. Once I get to that rocky outcropping over there, you're out of all the commercial stuff. And it's back to beaches and just shoreline. And it's got rocky shoreline, but nothing like the other side. This barge has been here forever too. We used to play on that thing when it was, you know, a fully intact barge back in the 70s. I don't know why they hadn't moved all this stuff. So I'm gonna go to the end of Altoona there if the battery holds, and that's where I'm cutting the video. And I'll start over there. Continue on with the trek, man. And we'll be getting into the better parts of the coast, the beaches, and yeah, not all this junk metal and commercialized stuff. Don't have to skip anything down here. I'd walk through there, but I don't want to get soaked and go around it. That's Altoona Lagoon. It's a big old lagoon in there. Damn, that's a big egret. Sucking key. I don't think I've ever seen one that big. This is the Altoona boat ramps. Yeah, next trip I'm gonna park at the marina. I got a friend there who lives on a boat. And then I'll start from there. Really nice weather we're having for this time of year. Normally it's a lot rougher and windy. thirsty, man. Yeah, it's the perfect weather for doing this. Sharp rocks on that. I guess, yeah, man, the mongoose is showing you more St. Croix, eh? I don't know, nobody's done this, filmed the whole coastline of St. Croix. Nowhere to go and not to go. Yeah, I gotta hike all the way back that way. I definitely ain't going back all that coast. Going the back roads. I'm gonna cut the video by that telephone pole over there. And then I'll start from there. Take a break. Drink my soda, man. Battery's got to be giving up soon. Wouldn't get much further in there anyhow. Hello. Water's pretty clear for here. All right. This is where I'm gonna end the video till the next one. I'll be starting right here.